Welcome students, once again we are starting with chapter number 4, that is retirement and death of a partner. Continuing from the last class where we have ended with retirement, today we will be concentrating on death of a partner. In this chapter we will be studying calculation of the amount due to deceased partner, how to calculate the profits based on time basis or turnover basis, and then what is the treatment of joint life policies in case of death, and then we will be completing with one full question on retirement. Let us start with the first point, that is how to calculate the amount to be credited and debited to the deceased partner. The amount to be credited are capital, accumulated profits, revaluation profits, goodwill credited, profits till the date of death, which we will be calculating on the basis of turnover or time basis, and interest on capital again till the date of death, share of joint life policy and salary, commission, etc. if it is there. What are the amounts to be debited to the partner? Drawings, accumulated losses, revaluation losses, goodwill written off. If existing goodwill is there, it has to be written off, and losses till the date of death, and interest on drawings. How to calculate profits till the date of death? There are two bases. First, time basis, and another is turnover basis. To start with time basis, let's take an example. Last year profit 2,40,000. If A dies after 3 months from the last balance sheet date, then how to calculate his share if ABC are sharing equally? 2,40,000 is the profit for the last 12 months. Assuming it to be on an even basis, we will calculate it for 3 months. That is 2,40,000 divided by 12 multiplied by 3, you get 60,000 rupees. And A share will be, as they are equal partners, 1/3 of 60,000, that is 20,000 rupees. Now, if we have to calculate the profits on turnover basis, let us again understand with an example. If the last year turnover was 10 lakh and the last year profit was 2 lakh, and turnover till the date of death is now 4 lakh rupees, the profits will be calculated in a proportionate manner. That is 2 lakh divided by 10 lakh into 4 lakh, which makes it 80,000. And we will calculate the deceased partner share as given in the question. Can be 5-3-2, it can be 3-2-1, it can be equal also. So, whatever is given in the question, we will calculate accordingly. The next point is how to treat the goodwill. It is just like the same as in retirement. So, there is no need of any discussion on that. Just follow the same principles which you have followed in retirement. Now, a very, very important point, treatment of joint life policies. There can be two cases. When we have taken individual joint life policy, that is in the name of each of the partner, and when we have taken joint life policy, one policy in the name of all the existing partners. Taking the first case, individual policy. Suppose there are three partners A, B, C, and we have taken three policies, one for A, one for B, and another for C. And suppose Mr. B dies. Now, what happens is, when somebody dies, his policy is realized in full. But the other persons who are alive, their policy will not be realized in full. But we will consider their surrender value for the purpose of distribution among all the partners. That is, A and C's policy surrender value will be considered, and B, who has died, his full value will be considered for the purpose of distribution among all the partners. Yes, all the partners, because the firm was paying the premium So everybody has a share in that. Maybe the full value, maybe the surrender value. All taken together, share will be calculated for the deceased partner and other also, and given to them in their profit sharing ratio, old profit sharing ratio. Okay. And in case we have taken only one policy, that is joint life policy, if any of them dies, we will get the full money. And when we get the full money, everybody has a share in that. All the partners will get share in that in old profit sharing ratio. So you have understood, in case of individual policy, one who has died will be realized in full, others surrender value, but divided in all the partners. And in case of joint life policy, full amount will be realized and that will be distributed among all. Let's do one full question on retirement to see whatever concepts we have told you, whether you have understood or not. Let's start with the question XYZ. There are three partners. They are sharing in the ratio 5-3-2. Balance sheet is given like this. Please see capital XYZ, creditor, reserves. We will distribute the capital and reserve in the capital account. And on the asset side, if there is any revaluation, we will consider it in revaluation account. So let's see the adjustments. What are they? Now, if Y retires and following adjustments has to be made. Stock is revalued at 20,000. You know it is 15,000 in the balance sheet. So if it is revalued at 20,000, 5,000 is the gain. Second point, provision for bad and doubtful debts not required now. It's again a profit for you. 5,000 will be credited in revaluation account. Plant depreciated by 10%. Plant value is given 50,000. So 10% will be 5,000. And it's a loss, it will be debited in revaluation account. Next point, 10,000 creditors are not likely to arise. Now that's a gain for you because creditors will be paid less amount. So this is a gain on the credit side of the revaluation account. So required is accounts and balance sheet and cash paid to Y. So we start with revaluation first. On the debit side, losses, that is depreciation of plant 5,000, and on the credit side, all the incomes, that is stock 5,000, provision not required 5,000, and creditors to be paid less 10,000. So this makes it 15,000 rupees profit, which will be distributed in the old ratio 5-3-2, and X will get 7,500, Y will get 4,500, and Z will get 3,000. As per their profit sharing ratio. In the capital account, we start with the opening balance on the credit side, XYZ 40, 30, 20. And then reserves will be distributed 20,000, 12,000, and 8,000. And then revaluation profit will be distributed 7,500, 4,500, and 3,000. And whatever the total is, it will be paid in cash to Y, and the remaining partners are still there. So that will be a balance carried down in the balance sheet. So Y will be paid 46,500, and the balance will be carried down to the balance sheet in which X and Z are still continuing. In the balance sheet, we see X and Z are still there with 67,500 and 31,000. And creditors, there is no change, 80,000. And on the asset side, cash has changed. Whatever amount is paid to Y has been deducted. And bank account, debtors account, stock, investment, and plant, those which have changed at new values and those which have not changed at the same value. And the balance sheet tallies in the end, 1,78,500. Let's start with one full question on death of a partner. Let's see this balance sheet, ABC, creditors, reserve, and on the asset side, building, machinery, stock, patent, debtors, and cash is given. A died on 1st October 2011. Now, following adjustment has to be done. First point, patents are valued at 8,000. So there is a change in the value. Machinery is valued at 28,000. Again, there is a change in the value, and that's a decline, which will be a loss. And profits are to be taken on the same basis as in previous year. And in the previous year, it was 20,000. Interest on capital is taken at 10% per annum. So you remember, interest is taken only till the date of death. And A has died on 1st October. So we will be considering interest for only 6 months, that is 1st April to 1st October. Next point is, half amount due to A paid and the remaining transferred to his loan account. And the ratio of ABC is 5:3:2. Required is prepare A capital account and A's executor account. Let's start with the solution. On the revaluation debit side, loss of patent will be there 3,000 and loss on the valuation of machinery 2,000, which makes the total loss 5,000 rupees, which will be distributed between A, B, C in their ratio 5:3:2. That is 2,500, 1,500 and 1,000 respectively. This will be taken to their capital account debit side. But because we are asked only about A capital account, so we'll be taking 2,500 to A capital account debit side. Let's move on to A capital account. In A capital account, we'll start with by balance 30,000, which is existing capital. And then we will give reserves to Mr. A, that is his share out of 6,000 rupees, half of that 3,000 rupees. And interest on capital, 30,000, 10% per annum, but only for 6 months. You remember, he died on 1st October. So, interest for only 6 months, that is 1,500 rupees. And profits will be distributed to him 5,000. How did we calculate this? Please see the note. Profit 20,000 into 6 upon 12. Because we have to consider profits only for 6 months. That makes it 10,000. And his share 5 upon 10 makes it 5,000 rupees. So that is credited to Mr. A capital account. And on the debit side, revaluation loss 2,500 is there. And the remaining amount is transferred to A's executor, 37,000 rupees. You remember, we have to pay half of this. So we will see that in A executor account, this amount is paid in half. Let's move on to A's executor account. On the credit side, we will transfer this 37,000 rupees. And on the debit side, we will pay half of that, that is 18,500 rupees. And the remaining will be transferred to his loan account. Now, he has not asked about the loan account, but if he asks, then it will be on the credit side of the loan account. And whatever we will pay along with interest, that will come on the debit side, as we have discussed in a previous question. So, in today's discussion, what we have learned is how to calculate the amount due to a deceased partner, that is, what is to be debited, what is to be credited in his account, how to calculate that joint life policy and individual life policies, and what is the treatment of revaluation account, and how to make his executor account. This completes our chapter on retirement and death of a partner. Thank you very much.